you feel your brake lever
or brake pedal
pulsing while you're braking?
And is your bike's braking performance not what it used to be?
Can you see black comet tails from the disc ventilation slots?
All this is due to the old brake pad material sitting on top of the brake disc and changing its surface properties. Contact cleaner, scotch pad, and clean rags. What common purpose could these three items serve? Well, they all play their role in our next video about deglazing our brake discs. Up next. I'm Dr. Vstrom, and today's video is all about deglazing your brake discs. Deglazing your brake discs is mandatory when replacing brake pads, but it's also a good habit for periodical brake maintenance. There are links up here for other brake maintenance videos to completely service your braking system. I have used my marker here to make these marks so as to illustrate what is known as black comet tails that usually form from the ventilation slots of the brake discs, and these are also known as brake disc stains. And what this is actually brake pad material that sits or forms on top of the brake disc. Now, why we need to get rid of this is because this actually results in reduced braking efficiency. This is because now the brake pads come in contact in some locations with a clean brake disc and in some others with the old brake pad dust dirt combination. This results in up to 10 to 15% reduced braking efficiency, as the clean brake disc area is also reduced. All brake discs eventually build up brake pad compound material over time, and this embeds itself into the disc, retaining heat and promoting disc warping. So in order to prevent this, you need to clean your discs. Do not mix this up or connect this with cars, as their rotors are usually iron based, whereas with motorcycles it's stainless steel, so cleaning is different. First step is to put the wheel that you want to work with up in the air. So you have to use a paddock stand for the front wheel, or a rear paddock stand, or a center stand for the rear wheel. Take a clean wet wipe and spin the wheel to remove all the hard dirt particles that might be on top of the brake disc. Take your Scotch-Brite pad. It can either be green or red. Then cut a small part, like so, fold it, press it against both brake disc sides, and then start to spin the wheel. While doing so, make sure that you move the scotch pad back and forth while the wheel is spinning, like so, so that in order to ensure that you scrub all the old brake pad material from the entire brake disc surface. Take your contact cleaner and your clean rag, apply the contact cleaner on the clean rag, and then perform the same back and forth movements as we did with the scotch pad in the previous step. As you can see, the clean rag comes out dirty. Once the rag comes back clean, our brake disc surface is ready to fully contact new or old brake pads. One last thing to do while servicing or maintaining your brake discs is to inspect their thickness, especially if your motorcycle is old. As you can see also written on the brake disc itself, the owner's service manual states the minimum thickness of either your front or rear brake disc. And in this case, the normal and limit thickness for this Vstrom is 4.5 millimeters. So you should check with your owner's service manual about your motorcycle. Of course, it goes without saying that if the thickness of your brake disc is less than the limit value specified from the service manual, you should consider replacing your brake discs. So take your caliper meter and using different locations of your brake disc, measure the actual thickness. In this case, you can see that it says 5.5 millimeters. And if you remember, our limit was 4.5 millimeters. So we are good. Okay, that is all about brake discs and their maintenance. So make sure to check the rest of my brake maintenance related videos. And of course, subscribe for more and leave your comments down below.